Joining me tonight, Union Minister Smriti Irani, the candidate of the BJP from Amethi. Good evening, Smriti Irani, and thank you for joining me. Smriti ji, आप अमेठी में पता नहीं कब से बसी हुई हैं और रैलीज कर रही हैं। आज एक ट्रैक्टर पर 12 लोगों की रैली निकली, वो रॉबर्ट वाड्रा का नाम ले रहे थे, पोस्टर भी आ गए रॉबर्ट वाड्रा जी के। आपको कौन अपना प्रतिद्वंदी लगता है? Who will be against you in अमेठी?
देखिए नाविका जी, मैं आभारी हूँ कि कम से कम आज देश को पता तो चल गया कि कांग्रेस के पास अब अमेठी में सिर्फ 12 लोग ही बचे हैं जो एक ही ट्रैक्टर में फिट हो जाएंगे। अब इस लोकतंत्र में सबका अधिकार है, कोई कहीं से भी चुनाव लड़ सकता है, लेकिन हाँ, कांग्रेस में लोकतंत्र सिर्फ उस परिवार तक सीमित है जिसमें, अगर आपका जो इंटरव्यू अभी चला मैंने सुना, उस व्यक्ति ने कहा सोनिया जी के दामाद हैं, प्रियंका जी के पति हैं, राहुल जी के जीजा जी हैं, इसलिए लोग गला लगाना चाहते हैं। प्रश्न ये उठता है कि यहाँ पर आकर गले लगने के लिए कोई प्रत्याशी नहीं चाह रहा, नाली खड़ंजा इंटरलॉकिंग का काम करवाने के लिए प्रत्याशी चाह रहा है। तो आज मैं स्वागत करूंगी, लाइक आई सेड, इन अ डेमोक्रेसी इट्स एवरी इंडियंस राइट टू फाइट इन इलेक्शन, चाहे वो कोई भी हो, उनकी हार यहाँ पर निश्चित है, ये वो भी जानते हैं, इसलिए अभी तक उन्होंने कैंडिडेट अपना अनाउंस नहीं किया। जैसे कि आपने प्रधानमंत्री जी का वक्तव्य चलाया, 26 तारीख को वायनाड का वोट हो जाएगा, उसके बाद वो अमेठी की ओर रुख करेंगे, और ये वो अमेठी है जहां पर 2022 में भी जब विधानसभा का चुनाव हुआ था तब दोनों श्रीमती वाड्रा और राहुल जी यहां पर बार बार पधारे। जगदीशपुर नाम के एक इलाके में तो पांच पांच उन्होंने सभाएं कर ली, लेकिन इस पूरी लोकसभा क्षेत्र में नाविका जी, चार विधानसभा क्षेत्र में उनकी जमानत जब्त हुई, और पांचवी विधानसभा का अगर आप पूरा वोट मिला लें पांचों विधानसभाओं का, तो लगभग 1,30,000 का उनका वोट है। 2019 में उनके पास लगभग 4,30,000 वोट था, 2022 में 1,30,000 वोट बचा, ये 24 है, तो 24 में क्या हश्र होगा ये गणित ही आपको बता देगा।
स्मृति रानी, राहुल गांधी जी के अंकल सैम पिट्रोडा जो उनके साथ बाहर विदेशों में व्हेन ही गोज टू कैम्ब्रिज, ऑक्सफोर्ड, बर्कले, मेनी ऑफ दीस प्लेसेस एंड मेक्स दोस स्टेटमेंट्स, द सेम सैम
पिट्रोडा, आई थिंक कैम्ब्रिज, ऑक्सफोर्ड एंड बर्कले विल रीथिंक देयर इनविटेशन टू अंकल सैम।
Yeah, but today he's come out and said that inheritance...
After the financial wizardry that he has spoken of.
So you think this is a statement that the Congress has distanced itself from? Do you think is actually a bogey? Or if it is seen, Sam Pitroda's statement seen with Rahul Gandhi's wealth redistribution plan, do you think this is the economic policy of the Congress if it were to come to power?
I don't think this was a slip of tongue. I don't think this is a happenstance. I think that the false bravado of not only Uncle Sam but also Mrs. Vadra and Rahul Gandhi's Machiavellian plan has been called out by the entire country. So let's for not a single second imagine that this is just an opinion or this is just a thought. This is a well-crafted framework on which the Congress leadership, particularly Rahul Gandhi and Priyanka Vadra, are working on. Now, leave aside Sam Pitroda. If you look at the verbal presentation by both Rahul Gandhi and Priyanka Vadra, they have been more than vehement that sabki kamai gini jayegi. They have not differentiated between anybody. They have marked out every Indian. Now, I managed to hear the last snippet of your debate previous to our conversation, and I think Shahzad Poonawalla was right. Ki pehle apni party mein apni political stronghold to redistribute karo. Now, the issue is, why are they so convinced that they should not only count the earnings and the properties and the holdings of every Indian citizen, and there is no economic bar that they have pronounced, they have said every Indian citizen. What Sam Pitroda has possibly today exposed is the fact that even after death, if there is anything left of what you have earned or you have inherited, 50% of it will be taken away if the Congress party ever gets power. As today in Amethi people have said, na chain se Congress jeene degi, na chain se Congress marne degi. The Prime Minister has been more eloquent and eruditely said ki Congress ki loot, जिंदगी के साथ भी जिंदगी के बाद भी. सो लेट्स नॉट फॉर अ मिनट थिंक दैट दिस इज अ स्लिप ऑफ टंग. लेट्स नॉट फॉर अ मिनट थिंक दैट दिस इज अ पॉलिटिकल हैपनस्टांस. दिस इज अ वेल क्राफ्टेड सिनर्जाइज्ड फ्रेमवर्क फॉर द कांग्रेस लीडरशिप दैट दे प्लान टू इंप्लीमेंट.
स्मृति ईरानी, द कांग्रेस पार्टी सेज that the BJP is on the back foot after the first phase of polling, which is why it's fear-mongering, because not the Congress has given its clarification. This is an opinion of Sam Pitroda alone.
See, if the Congress was extremely confident of winning Lok Sabha 2024, do you think many of their senior leaders would have gone to Rajya Sabha? In fact, from the adjoining constituency of Rai Bareli, why did Mrs. Gandhi pack up her electoral schedule vis-a-vis the Lok Sabha elections if they were so confident of winning across the country? Why is it that they have not announced a candidate yet from Amethi? Do you think, and Navika, you've had a long history in political reportage, do you think it is feasible or possible for the Congress party in just 20 days to hike up 10% of the vote share in Amethi just because Rahul Gandhi and Priyanka Vadra will come and wave at the crowds? And let me then rephrase that, 12 people on a tractor.
But Mrs. Gandhi,
so I think this false
Mrs. Bivado, Gandhi, it could be because of health reasons, move to the Rajya Sabha.
Is suffering from? Now, the issue at hand is that the lady is too senior in age, and I'm not talking politically. Chronologically, so old that I would not like to get into a sparring match with you on it. However, people who are incapable of serving politically in a Lok Sabha constituency then do not make themselves available for political positions and political rallies and tours across the country.
So
that notwithstanding, are you saying that the Congress party in Rai Bareli and Amethi has taken things for granted so much so that they've not announced a candidate where your election is just 25 days away? Look at what they did in Western UP in the first phase. They went and did a press conference, one, on the last day of political campaign. Do they think that just by Rahul Gandhi sitting there in a press conference and saying, "Arey, tum BJP ke reporter ho, they'll win an election?" Where did Mrs. Vadra go and campaign? She went and campaigned for a Congress candidate who said, "Modi ki main boti boti kar dunga," didn't she? So look at their choices. Look at their political strategies. And forget, look at us. Look at what their own partners in their alliance are saying about them. Mamata Bandyopadhyay has clearly stated, if Rahul Gandhi is anywhere near the alliance, as the leader of the alliance, they will lose in front of Narendra Modi. Look at what the Kerala chief minister says about his so-called alliance partner Rahul Gandhi, that whenever in this country there's an issue of importance that needs to be discussed, Rahul Gandhi disappears. So why blame the BJP? Look at what their own alliance partners are saying.
Smriti Irani, you commented...
Now, in the second phase, which is just 2 days away,
okay,
Ms. Kumar, the second phase, which is 2 days away, the country does not know who the Indy Alliance prime ministerial candidate is. And you tell me, is Congress seriously fighting this election?
So let me ask you...
Do they have the guts to declare Rahul Gandhi as their prime ministerial candidate?
No, they can't, simply because the India Alliance
so.
Will...
Why aren't they? Because even they know, that it's politically suicidal to name either Rahul Gandhi or Srimati Vadra as a prime ministerial candidate. Notwithstanding, unke damad ko kitne log kahan gale laga rahe hain. And when you're talking about that they can't go against an alliance, what alliance? An alliance that is throwing chairs at each other in a Ranchi rally?
Well, Smriti Irani, let me ask you, Jija ji ki nazar, Saleh sahab kya karenge, unhone to rumal rakh diya, aapne kaha. Do you find it strange that Robert Wadra is giving interviews, coming out publicly and saying that people want him to fight from Amethi, and there's radio silence from the Congress party, from Rahul Gandhi on this entire issue, when everybody was expecting this to be a seat where Rahul Gandhi would come?
I don't know the family dynamics. I don't know the family dynamics, and very honestly, neither is it my right to invade in somebody's private family moments, nor I think it's politically prudent, because honestly, a pragmatic political activist would not take the name of Robert Wadra or Rahul Gandhi very seriously in Amethi. Why? Because we have 5 years of a candidate from the Bharatiya Janata Party who, in coordination with the government at the center and the state, has worked in every Gram Panchayat. If today you ask anybody in Amethi, kya Rahul ji ko ye pata hai Bhetua kaha hai, Bhadar kaha hai, Singhpur kaha hai, Sangrampur kaha hai, Mahona kaha hai, Inhona kaha hai, Panhona kaha hai, Chhato kaha hai, D kaha hai, Haliapur kaha hai? Let alone Rahul Gandhi, Mr. Wadra, who claims that he has known Amethi since the 90s, he wouldn't know.
Are you overconfident?
And they've had success in electoral politics in this area for 50 years.
But are you overconfident
now for the Gandhi
election?
Family to rule the roost for 50 years in one Lok Sabha constituency? Navika, just one intervention, please.
Go ahead.
In the last 5 years, of which 2 years we had Corona, in 5 years, the Modi government only in Amethi has helped build over 4 lakh toilets in individual households. If you just do the rudimentary maths of 4 people per family, that means in a constituency which has 2.5 million people, 1.6 million people did not have a toilet in 50 years of the Gandhi family's rule. Narendra Modi, in only 5 years, has managed to build 1,14,000 homes for the poor. Modi, in just 5 years, only in Amethi, has given 3,50,000 families tap water for the first time. There are 40 villages which never had electricity, 1.5 lakh homes which never had electricity. Today, before coming to your interview, I was in a constituency called Jagdishpur, which Mr. Wadra claims he knows. In Jagdishpur, there is a place called Shukal Bazar. If the Gandhis know their area well, they are answerable to the people. Why in Shukal Bazar? And you go and find out. Your reporters are available. Shukal Bazar mein Bhagavat ki katha nahi hone dete the Gandhi khandan ke gunde. Wahan par 2016 से भारतीय जनता पार्टी के कार्यकर्ताओं को खड़े होकर लोगों को सपोर्ट देना पड़ता था ताकि भागवत की कथा हो जाए. वहां बीएचईएल पे रोड नंबर 1 है, पता नहीं इनको पता है कि नहीं वो सड़क कहां है. वहां पर शाम को लड़कियां ट्यूशन से अगर घर लौटती थी तो इनके गुंडे सड़क पर कोने में खड़े होकर लड़कियों के दुपट्टे खींचते थे. आप इमेजिन कर सकते हैं, जहां 15 साल राहुल गांधी सांसद रहे, जब वो सांसद थे तो लोग भागवत कथा नहीं होने देते थे.
स्मृति रानी,
दैट इज व्हाई फॉर एवरीबडी एल्स हु इज वॉचिंग अस, अमेठी वाज ऑलवेज पोजिशन्ड एज दिस वीआईपी हॉटस्पॉट. बट इमेजिन 16 लाख इंडियंस ओनली इन दिस वन कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी विच हैड द गांधी फैमिली फॉर 50 ईयर्स डिड नॉट हैव अ टॉयलेट.
Well, but
people who could not build toilets in one constituency are talking about counting every Indian's wealth, redistributing it at will, and then not even leave your hard-earned money after you die. आप redistribution of wealth की पिछले segment में बात कर रही थी नाविका जी, आपकी यहाँ पूरी reporting team आज खड़ी है. मेरा आग्रह है यहाँ से बस 20 मिनट दूर गौरीगंज में एक फैक्ट्री की वहां पर जमीन पड़ी थी जो कांग्रेस पार्टी की कहने पर स्टेट गवर्नमेंट ने एक फैक्ट्री चलाने वाले को दी. सडनली फैक्ट्री वाले ने कहा नहीं मेरे पास पैसे नहीं है, और उठाकर राहुल गांधी की फाउंडेशन ने ले ली. बोर्ड पर राहुल जी हैं, प्रियंका जी हैं, सोनिया जी हैं. 10 साल से हम लोग कह रहे हैं किसान की जमीन लौटा दो. ये किसान की जमीन खाए बैठे हैं अमेठी में, और रीडिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ वेल्थ की बातें करते हैं देश में? आप यहां से आधा घंटा दूर चले जाइए मुंशीगंज, 30 साल पहले वहां पर इन्होंने 30 एकड़ जमीन ली है 600 रुपए देकर, सरकार की जमीन, ये कहकर कि सरकारी मेडिकल कॉलेज बनवाएंगे। नरेंद्र मोदी प्रधानमंत्री बने तो यहां सरकारी मेडिकल कॉलेज बना, इनको शर्म नहीं आती? यहां सरकारी कॉलेज के नाम पर जमीन खा गए 30 एकड़, आज तक सरकार को भूमि नहीं लौटाई है। एंड दे विल रीडिस्ट्रीब्यूट वेल्थ, दे विल रॉब एवरी इंडियन फैमिली, टेक अवे योर इकोनॉमिक अपॉर्चुनिटीज सो दैट दे फिल देयर कॉफर्स। पहले देश की तिजोरी पर नजर थी, अब जनता की जेब पर नजर है।
Smriti Irani, the battle lines are drawn and this election
Rahul and Priyanka stand for.
Absolutely, and this election will determine who the people of India will choose.
पूरी फौज तैयार है नाविका
जी,
हमारी पूरी फौज तैयार है, उनके 12 लोग ट्रैक्टर पर आज भी कैंडिडेट ढूंढ रहे हैं, ये फर्क है।
Well, शब्दों में, लफ्जों में, वर्ड्स में आपसे कोई नहीं जीत सकता स्मृति ईरानी। सवाल सिर्फ इतना है कि अमेठी कौन आएगा और आपसे क्या जीत पाएगा, जनता इस सवाल के जवाब का इंतजार कर रही है।
जीजा हो या साला नाविका, जीजा हो या साला, अमेठी में हर वोटर है मोदी का मतवाला।
वेल, वी विल वेट एंड वॉच। थैंक यू वेरी मच स्मृति ईरानी।